And here in Appalachia, one of the biggest invasive species we have is kudzu. We developed a study to control invasive species in conjunction with modern forestry practices. Traditionally, when removing invasive species, it takes a lot of man hours and a lot of time on the ground. So we would have to go in with a chainsaw and a crew, cut out each individual plant, which in this case is kudzu, and then spray it. That's the traditional way to do it. And we did this in the past with a very low result. Next year, it didn't look like we had done any work. So we developed a study where we can use goats to restore forestry, save man hours, all at the same time. So what we did is we found an area in our forest that had a kudzu problem. First step was to establish your area that you were going to work in, which was our 3rd acre plot over by our watersheds. And then we fenced the area to hold the goats and built all of our infrastructure that we needed. So after that, we walked the perimeter of the area and mapped it through arc maps, made a GPS model map of the area. Then we went into arc maps and laid a GPS coordinate grid over top of it electronically and generated 3 different distinct areas within the map. And those areas happened to be a riparian zone, the hillside, which is what a lot of the property was, in a disturbed area because we had a recent tree fall in the area and that affected the data that would be collected.
I did what's called a fishnet in GIS and put plots every so often. You know, I put like 200 plots within our study area, and then I selected randomly through the computer for those points, and then took those points and transferred them from the computer onto the GPS to go here. Now, unfortunately, in this area, the satellite reception is low, so it's only accurate to within 10 or 15 feet. So what we're doing when we go from plot to plot is we are getting a rough estimate where it is, and then we are just throwing our stick there to keep our bias out of it, so we don't select for a place that has less kudzu or something. Should keep our statistics in line.
We randomly generated 70 plots, 70 areas with dots within the 1/3 of an acre plot, and we used a meter square to center of every one of those GPS spots. And while we did that, we marked it with a stake and a tag so that we knew which number coordinated with which GPS point. Within that meter square, we took 3 measurements. We took the kudzu density, the percent kudzu, other in kudzu, and the height. And we did the density on a 1-5 sliding scale, and the percentage obviously is a 0-100% based on how much cover was within the meter square. So we took data on all these points and went into ArcMaps and linked the data that we collected to each GPS point. That way it can be analyzed in the future. After that, we took goats. We had 11 goats that we put on the plot. The goats were accompanied by a Great Pyrenees herd dog, so that was there for protection, and we would check them daily. We put the goats out there. The project lasted for 8 days. In 8 days, they had cleared a vast majority of the kudzu, and we removed the goats and went back and took the data from the 70 different plots again, which allowed us to put it into Excel and transport into the ArcMaps program and see a visual before and after of the goats and solve the problem. I think that goats are a highly underutilized animal that in Appalachia, and I think that with an invasive species problem that we have and the availability of goats, it'd make a lot more sense to go in and do invasive species management like that instead of using man hours, paid work, and harmful chemicals.